गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। ओके, वी स्टार्ट टुडेज क्लास। So good morning. In the yesterday class, we had completed the shell casting and the shell molding and an investment casting, right? So and we had also completed what is meant by plaster molding. So in the present class, we will learn about what is meant by permanent mold casting, what is meant by die casting, what is a hot chamber die casting and a cold chamber die casting. Clear? So you had got some idea what is meant by casting. Again, revision of your syllabus. So you had got some idea related to casting and what is the different methods are to be get done in the casting. So what type of molds are to be get used? What type of molten metals can be get used? And what type of core and what type of properties must be get consists of each and every mold and as well as the core. So up to what extent the mold can be get withstand? So this you came to know, understand what is what. So up to what temperature, so and so casting mold can be get heated. So what type of patterns can be get used. So these are the nothing but which we have learned in the yesterday class. So in the present day, we will learn about what is meant by permanent mold casting. So clear? So in a permanent mold casting, this is also one of the mold casting process which comes under the casting. So basic permanent mold process. So what is the basic things required in a permanent mold casting? So it is the uses of a metal mold constructed of two sections designed for easy, precise opening and a closing. So the basic thing in a permanent mold casting is it is made up of a two different molds. One is a fixed mold and another is a moving mold. So the molds for lower melting point alloys, steel or cast iron, and molds for steel refractory material and due to the very high pouring temperature. So whatever the molds, it is made up of a very lower melting point alloys. Clear? Made up of a normally a steel or a cast iron. So molds for the steel, it is a refractory material due to the very high pouring temperatures. So what is the basic process is going on in a permanent mold casting is you have to going to be taking a two molds. One is a fixed mold, the other is a moving mold. So in a fixed mold, we are going to be placing the pattern which is made up of a resin and a water. It is to be get prepared by using some heating nature. It is to be get prepared and it is to be placed in a fixed mold. So above to that, a moving mold is to be get placed. And again, the molten metal is to be get poured, and up to the it is to be get solidified. The molten metal, the plunger where you are going to pushing to get solidified, it is to be get removed, and after that you are going to be getting a certain type of shapes. So in this permanent mold casting, it purely explains that you will get a good surface finish and a good dimensional accuracy also. So the fine grain due to the rapid solidification, as I had told in the last class, whatever the core, whatever the resin or binder, whatever you are going to be taking, it must be having very fine grain particles, not a very large grain particles. So you are also learn about what is meant by a sleeve analysis also. So if through the sleeve analysis, we can from the basins and from the pan, you can separate what is the different types of grains can be getting. So that is to be get separated. So by using those type of thing, it can be get done and we can get a fine grain particles and which can be get used. Clear? So now we will go to the one by one step by step process. The first one is the two halves of the mold are made of a metal, usually the cast iron, steel or a refractory alloys. So whatever the tool, the two half molds, one is a fixed mold, the other is the moving mold. So it is made up of a cast iron, steel or a refractory alloys. So the cavity including the runners, gating system are machined into the mold halves. So when the molten metal is to be get poured, it must be having some runners, some sprues and risers and as well as a gating system. It must be get there. So that is to be get inbuilted in the molds. It is to be get inbuilted in the molds. So for half, for hollow parts, either permanent cores made of a steel or a sand bonded ones may be used, depending on whether the core can be extracted from the part without damage after the casting. So it must be, the molds must be arranged in a position so that after the part is to be get solidified, it can be get removed easily without having some damage. So in the permanent mold casting, the main advantage is no need to prepare the pattern at each and every time. No need to prepare a pattern each and every time. The mold is totally permanent. It is directly having some type of shape, what type of production you are going to get required. So depends on the shape, depends on the size, what you want, depends on that one, the total mold is prepared. So it is a permanent one. It is a permanent one. It cannot be get spoiled also. So here the one of the, it is somewhat expensive only to prepare that molds, but it is not a wastage of time. It is not a wastage of time so that it can be used for many of the production particle, many of the productions also. Either it is in a mass or a job or a batch. So what type of production you need, it can be get used. So for hollow, for the surface of the mold is coated with a clay or other hard refractory material. This improves the life of the mold. So before molding, the surface is covered with a spray of a graphite or a silica, which acts as a lubricant. So this has two purposes. It improves the flow of the liquid metal and it also the cast part to be withdrawn from the mold more easily. So see, when you are going to be preparing, when your mother is going to be preparing some sweet in your home, so what your mother used to be do, she used to be get apply some ghee on the plate so that after it is to be get getting some type of temperature, the sweet can be get removed in a smooth manner. So the ghee is to be used for to apply so that the pieces can be get a very smooth flow. Yes or not? The same manner here also, after completing the solidification process and you want to remove the part, you want to remove the products from the total molding process. So what we are using is, we are going to be using some type of spray. Some spray is to be get applied, covered with the surface, which covers the surface. So it is applied on the molding before you are going to be starting your thing. So the spray is made up of somewhat graphite or a silica. So silica is nothing but a sand particles, what you know. Clear? So the next one is, the process can be automated. So therefore yields high throughput rates and it produces very good tolerance and very surface finish. It is to be having a good surface finish and very good tolerance. So it is commonly used for the producing pistons used in a car engines. So gear blanks, cylinder heads and the other parts made up of a very low melting point metals. So example, copper, bronze, aluminium, magnesium, etc. So the car piston, the dimensions of the, depends on the car, the size of the piston is to be get made because the engine. So for that one, so mold is to be get prepared. So after that, the melting, the molten metal is to be get poured and melting was done and solidification was completed. So for those type of the permanent things, which is having a very low melting points, it is to be get used under a permanent moly casting process. Dear students, and the examples of that one is copper, bronze, aluminium and magnesium. Okay, so the advantage is good surface finish and dimensional control and a fine grain due to a rapid solidification. So the disadvantage is the simple geometric part and is expensive mold. Yes, to prepare a mold, it is more expensive. It is more expensive because you are going to be choosing any cast iron or any magnesium or any steel, any type of the materials which is having a suitable lower melting point. So depends on that one, you are going to be choosing, you are going to be designing. So it takes somewhat hard time and it is more expensive because the materials, whatever you are choosing, is expensive. So by using some type of machines, it is to be get made also. Clear? So we will see what is the example. So we will watch the video. So as I had told you, the permanent mold cavity. So which is having the cavity, the mold shape, what you want to get prepared, right? And it is to be get attached to prepare some pattern. With the help of a resin, it is to be get poured. Sand mixture, which is to be get poured into the core. So that is nothing but a tool, which is to be get used. And it is to be get heated. So that you will get a certain type of pattern. And it is placed. Again, the same process is removed. The same process, you are going to get another part, and after that a gravity cast tools is closed. So here the molten metal is to be get poured into the gravity casting tool. So when the molten metal was poured, whatever, after it gets solidified, it can be easily get taken because the resin binder, it is very very smooth. So when the heating is to be get applied, what happens, it can be easily get breakdown. So you will be get form a shells. So metal solidifies, the gravity cast tool opens and the parts are to be get removed. So these are nothing but the gating systems. So you are getting a fine finish of a part. So here the surface finish was good and the dimension accuracy was good. So in this one, the tolerances, what you want to put, it is accurate. It is not a precision. Clear? So you will see the diagram which was given in the file. So here the part is, it is commonly used for the producing pistons used in a car engines. Example is the gear blanks, cylinder heads and other parts made of a low melting point. Example, a copper, bronze, aluminium, magnesium, etc. So here the first thing is, yeah, it is a fixed part, it is a moving part, moving table and a fixed table. So in the fixed table, you are going to be having the mold cavity, what you want to get prepared, what is the design you get want. So it is to be get sprayed. And what I had told you, it is the spray, what you are going to be using is a silica or a graphite, so that it, after completion of the solidification, the part can be easily get removed. So the total mold cavity is to be get sprayed. And after that, with the hydraulic cylinder to open and close the mold. So this is to be used to move the table, the other one of the half of the part of the mold. So the second position, the both the mold cavities are to be get closed, and after that the third position is the molten metal is to be get poured. After it is to be get solidified, it is to be get removed again in the back process. So the total two half parts is to be get removed. Clear? So in this is the correct manner which gives a good surface finish and a good dimensional accuracy. Okay, so the more rapid solidification caused by the cold metal mold results in a fine grain structure, so stronger castings are produced. So the limitations are generally limited to metals of lower melting point, simple part geometries compared to sand casting because of the need to be open the mold. Here, so it is to be used very simple parts, not a very hard, difficult or a complex or intricate shapes. So it is of the high cost of the mold. Due to the high mold cost, the process is best suited for the automated high volume production. So what I had told you, it depends on the production. It is to be get prepared. So the basic, the permanent mold casting is purely used for a high production. It is nothing but a mass production or a batch production. Because in a batch production also, we are going to be prepared a batch of pieces. So for those type of production, this process can be get used, but not for a job production. Clear, students? So the we will go to the die casting now. So the testing of the mold and a coarse sand, which we already yesterday it was get completed. Again, we will see. So the preparation of the standard test specimen, the mold hardness test, core hardness test, moisture content test on a foundry sand, sieve analysis, clay content test and a permeability test, compression and a shear test. So this all comes under, you are going to be testing the mold and as well as a core. How the core was there and how the mold was there, whether it is having any cracks or any other thing, and the mold come to the core, whether it is having a good moisture content or not, whether it is having good clay content or not, whether it can be get used to get a certain pattern or not. So what type of things testing is to be get done on a mold and as well as a core. So now comes to the die casting. So by the name die casting, you can get understand it is using a die. It is using a die. The die casting is to be get done. By the name we can get explained. So the die casting is a very commonly used type of permanent mold casting process. It is a very commonly used part. So it is used for producing many components of home appliances. Example, rice cookers, stoves, fans, washing and drying machines, fridges, motors, toys and hand tools. So these are the example. Mostly it is used for home appliances. The die casting is to be get used. So the molten metal is injected into the mold cavity die under the high pressure, which is 7 to 350 MPa. So the die, in the die casting, it explains under the two different, one is a hot chamber die casting. The second one is a cold chamber die casting here. So the in both the things, we are going to be taking a molten metal only. You are not taking a hard metal. It is taking a molten metal only. But there is a little difference between a hot chamber casting and a die chamber casting. That is, in a hot chamber casting, the total thing was dipped in a molten metal cavity. It is dipped in a molten metal cavity. And afterwards, it is to be get heated continuously. It is to be get heated continuously. And it was connected to the injector nozzle and the fixed chamber and as well as a mobile chamber. But whereas a cold chamber, you are going to be taken a molten melting metal. So what are the molten metal? You are going to be get considered and it is to be get poured continuously. It is to be get poured continuously. But whereas in a hot chamber, you had taken a molten metal in a chamber, in a some chamber or some cavity. So below that, it is to be get continuously burned. It is to be continuously burned. It is to be in the furnace. It is to be in the furnace. So after that, from the molten metal, you are going to putting some force on the molten metal so that through the injector nozzle, the molten metal is to be get injected, and through the gates, it is to be goes to the correct pattern and it is to be get solidifies. So that is the difference, main difference between a hot chamber and a cold chamber. Don't think that it is very, very much difference. It is only having a very small difference. Okay. But the, there is the materials what you are going to be used, it is having somewhat difference. Because what in a hot chamber, what you are going to be doing, the molten metal is continuously placed in a furnace. So for, when you are going to place in a furnace, that type of materials is to be get choosed. But whereas in a cold chamber, you are going to be taken, the melted molten metal is to be get taken. It is not placing in a furnace. So it is in a one type of chamber. Clear? So that is the main difference. So here the die casting, the molten metal is injected into the mold cavity under the high pressure of 7 to 350 MPa. So the pressure maintained during the solidification. So the one is hot chamber, the pressure is 7 to 35. And the injection system is submerged under the molten metal. So what I had told, the total injection system was submerged in the molten metal. It is not in an environment. It is totally dipped in a molten metal. So the low melting point metals such as lead, zinc, tin, magnesium are purely used for a hot chamber machines. So the next one, cold chamber, the pressure is of 14 to 140 MPa. So the external melting container, in addition, aluminium, brass and a magnesium. So it is not consists in a chamber. It is not submerged in a molten metal. It is totally in outside part. So we are going to be attaching some container so that the molten metal is to be get taken and it is to be get pushed or with the help of some plunger or any other thing. So some force is to be get applied which flows towards the die cavity. Clear? So the molds are made up of a tool steel, mold steel, marging steel, and a tungsten and a molybdenum. So these all having some different types of compositions like a nickel or a chromium or any other thing. So those type of compositions are to be get there for all. So the next one is single or a multiple cavity. So the lubricants and ejector pins to free the parts. So here the ejector pins are used basically because before the machine was to be get started, due to these pins, the machine is to be get closed. So after the solidification is completed, these pins are to be get removed and the part which was solidified and you, whatever the part you had get a final product, it is to be get removed. Clear? So for that sake, the ejector pins is having a very good content there. So the next point. So venting holes and pass away dies in the die. Venting holes and passageways in a die. So I already told you what is meant by vent holes. So the formation of the flash that needs to be get trimmed. So what is the properties of a die casting? So before knowing the properties, we will see the video what it is going to be. So this is a die casting process. So where it is having a correct die. So one is a fixed chamber, the another is a moving part. So for the one container, one molding part, a cavity was placed. Through this, the molten metal is to be get poured. So when both the molds are to be get collides, the molten metal is to be get taken through the cavity and it is to be get injected into the mold. So some force is to be get applied with the help of a plunger. so that the molten metal can be get flowed easily into the cavity. Without any gaps. So some force is to be get applied for that. And so the plunger will be get constant until it is to be get solidifies. Until it is to be get solidified. It is not to be get open. So the material cools in the mold. So after that, the parts are to be get removed. So can you observe this one? This is a mold cavity. Sorry, this is a gating system. This is a gating system, the gap which we are going to be having. And this is a sprue. And pins eject the mold part from the parts. Ejected sprue is removed from the two cavities. So this is the total thing which was going to be done in a die casting, right? So now you have got some point. What is meant by die casting and what is the process which was done in a die casting? So what is the minimum pressure is to be get applied? So 7, it is a main. So the properties of a die casting are huge numbers of the small light castings can be produced with a great accuracy. Little surface finishing is required. Permanent mold. So dies can be used over and over. So what I had told is here, it is nothing but a permanent mold. It can be used a number of times. It can be reused. It is not to be get wastage. So the advantage is the high production, economical, close tolerance, good surface finish, thin sections, and a rapid cooling. So it is having a high production. So when you want a high production particle products, it can be get used because the die was permanent and a permanent molds are permanent. What are the permanent molds which is going to be having a die cavities? So it is an economical, the close tolerance can be get done. So which is a very, very nearly tolerance. So good surface finish, thin sections, and a rapid cooling. Clear, students? So now under the die casting, you are having it two parts. One is a hot chamber die casting. The second one is a cold chamber die casting. So we will see the hot chamber die casting. So in a hot chamber process, the same process which was going to be done in a die casting, the process was same, but the arrangement of your parts is to be get different. Arrangement of the different parts is different. So in a hot chamber process, the use for a zinc alloys, magnesium, the pressure chamber connected to the die cavity is filled permanently in the molten metal. It is filled permanently in the molten metal. So the basic cycle of the operation is as follows. So I had already told you the total injector cavity is placed in a molten metal. So this is the molten metal. This is the injector part, injector nozzle. So which is, it is nothing but a nozzle. So it is placed in a molten cavity only. So the basic cycle of an operation is as follows. The die is closed and the gooseneck cylinder is filled with the molten metal. So this is a gooseneck cylinder. So this die is totally closed. It is closed. So for the injector nozzle, one die was to be get fixed. It is not removed. It is not removed. It is fixed. And this another mold, it is to be get moving in a one direction. So the plunger pushes the molten metal through the gooseneck passage. Through the gooseneck passage, it is to be get pushed. With the help of it, the plunger is to be get pushed. The plunger is to be get pushed so that the molten metal carries through the injector nozzle. It flows towards the cavity. It flows towards the die cavity. So until it fills, until the molten metal is filled in the total die cavity, it is to be get pushing. The pushing was to be get done. So the plunger pushes the molten metal through the gooseneck passage and nozzle and into the die cavity. So the metal is held under pressure until it solidifies. So what I had told you, until it gets solidifies, the plunger is to be in a pressure motion only. So the next one, the die opens and cores. If any are retracted, casting stays in an ejector die, plunger returns and pulling the molten metal back through the nozzle and a gooseneck. So if any of the molten metal was stay back in the injector nozzle, so what it happens is the plunger is to be get moving in up and down motion in continuously. So if it is remaining any of the molten metal, it can be get back. Okay. So the ejector pins push casting out of the ejector die. As plunger uncovers the inlet hole, molten metal refills the gooseneck cylinder. So the hot chamber process is used for the metals that have the low melting points and do not alloy with the die material. So the steel common examples are a tin, zinc and a lead. So whatever the material metals having a very low melting point, those type of metals are to be get chosen under a hot chamber die cast. Clear, students? So this is a total furnace thing. It is a pot. It is in the shape of a pot. So here the total molten metal cavity is to be get burned at each and every minute. So here the plunger is to be get taken. So in a chamber, the plunger and the molten metal, it is made up of a zinc or any other thing, was taken. So after that, it is nothing but a gooseneck. It is in a, some inclined position. It is not in a straight path so that it can be easily get back to the die cavity. So a further plunger part from the plunger cylinder, it is connected to an injector nozzle. So from the injector nozzle, it is having some gating system. So through that, the molten metal can be easily carried out over the die cavity. So from the gating system, the molten metal is to be get passed to the die cavity. So until it is to be get solidified, the plunger cannot be get removed towards the back position. Okay. So after it is to be get solidified, the two, the fixed mold and as well as a movable mold is to be get diffracted. Okay. So now we will see what is the video. Clear, students? So that is a hot chamber casting. So this is the total chamber, this is the plunger head and it is a fixed and it is a moving die. So what I had told you, it is a fixed die. So these are the ejector plate. It is a furnace. So I had told you the total system was placed in a furnace. It is continuously burned. The molten metal. So the die is closed. The moving chamber comes to the fixed chamber. The die is closed. So but the ram, with the help of a ram, some force is to be get applied. So this is the inlet port, the small circle. It is an inlet port where the molten metal is to be carried out through the pipe. So it is an inlet nozzle, what I had told you. So when the ram is raised, some inlet is going to be get taken. So it opens the inlet port in the chamber and allows the molten metal to fill the chamber. So through the nozzle, the molten metal is to be carried out, and this is nothing but a gating system. The small vise which you looks like, it is nothing but a gates, so that the molten metal is to be get carried out over the die cavities. So the plunger is forced down for the closing port and the forcing molten metal into the cavity. So until it is to be get solidify, the plunger will be in the same position only. It cannot be moved to the upward direction. So after solidification, the die will be open and you will get the ejector parts. Clear? So that comes under the hot chamber die casting. Clear, friends? The one is the chamber, the pot, and in this one you are going to placing a molten metal with the help of a plunger. The pressure is to be get applied, and it is going to be having an inlet port. You are where you are going to be seeing a small hole. It is nothing but an inlet port. So the from that you are going to be carrying out the molten metal. So when the plunger is to be get moving in a downward direction, the flow is to be get taken over to the inlet nozzle and it passing over to the die cavity. So after the it is to be get solidified, the plunger is to be get removed to its original position. So after that, the moving and a fixed is to be get removed. It comes to its original position, so that the final part is to be get over. Okay, na? So that is nothing but your hot chamber die casting. So now we will see what is a cold chamber die casting. So there is a difference between a cold chamber and a hot chamber. It is a very simple difference. Here is, it is not having any furnace or any other thing. It is going to be having using a molten metal. It is to be get taken the molten metal. The same process, the pressure is to be get applied through a plunger, and the molten metal is to be get taken and over to the inlet nozzle, and it is to be passed over to the die cavity, and after it is a die, it is to be get solidify, each and every parts is to be get removed back. Okay, now so the same process, but here you are not taking a furnace. That is the difference. Okay, so comes under the cold chamber die casting. In a cold chamber process, the molten metal is poured into the cold chamber. In each cycle, the operating cycle, the die is closed and the molten metal is ladled into the cold chamber cylinder. So plunger pushes the molten metal into the die cavity. So the metal is held under the high pressure until it solidifies. So die opens and the plunger follows to push the solidified slug from the cylinder. If there are cores, they are retracted away. So ejector pins push the casting off ejector die, and the plunger returns to its original position. Okay. So we will have a revision. What is going to be happening? So one is the shell molding. What you have learned in yesterday class. How the shells are to be get prepared. So what is how it is to be get heated, how the furnace, and how many times it is to be get tilted, so that the binder is to be get attaches over the pattern. So after that, how the shell is to be get removed and how it is to be get attached. So how the molten metal is to be get poured and solidifies. The same we had learned about the investment casting. So what are the different parts? The pattern here is used as the wax pattern. So you are going to be taking a sprue, which is also having a gate systems. So for each and every gate system, the individual wax pattern is to be get used. So individual wax pattern is to be get attached for the sprue. So after that, the total tree is to be get dipped in a some cavity. It is having a some slurry. And after the metal slurry was the first process, after that what is to be get done is the total tree is to be taken into the stucco coating. So the stucco coating is to be carried out 3 to 4 times, so that the first coating over the stucco coating is to be get carried out. So the stucco coating is going to be having a more thickness because the inside the wax was there, and after that the heating is to be get done. So when the heating was done, the total wax is to be get melted. So the this wax can be used for the next process also. So when the wax is to be get removed off from the total shells, so the total patterns are formed in a shell part. So from the sprue, the molten metal is to be get poured, and from the gates, each and every box, the molten metal is to be get carried out. And after that, you will be getting a final piece. This is the last class we had learned. So today's it is the permanent mold casting. So in a permanent mold casting, you are going to be using a permanent mold, and some type of dyes are to be get used here. Some type of molten metals are to be get used. So what is the procedure and everything? So how, what is the advantages of this one? Whether it is a good surface finish or dimension control was there or not? So the next. So this is what we are going to be get explained. What is the permanent die casting, and what is a die casting? We are also learn about what is the testings to be get done in a mold and as well as a core sand. So this is a hot chamber die casting and a cold chamber die casting. So what is the process is to be get done in a hot chamber die casting? So in the next class we will discuss about the cold chamber die casting, right?
Oh, madam.